It's Tuesday the 27th of December 2016. A late night live show for you today, gang. Thank you very much to those of you that were testing our little stream earlier. Oh, I've just managed... Very cold out there, dear. Oh, brr. Minus degrees today. Probably not as cold as it is in Canada at the moment. Let's just say hello to a few people nice and quickly. Oh, good afternoon to, good evening to Justin Peacock, who runs that pokey little pub up north. How are you, Justin? Hope you're well this evening. How was your Christmas Eve? Do tell us, dear. Do tell us. I used to DJ at Justin's place in Hemel Hempstead for quite a number of years on Christmas Eve. And then for 1 year, it went very quiet. And the customers changed over. They started coming during the daytime instead of the nighttime. It must have been my DJing, dear. It had got that bad that they didn't come at night anymore. Is that right? Justin says, exciting, just like waiting for Thora Heard on Praise Be. Praise be the Lord. Oh, yes. Yes. Oh, incidentally, this shirt I'm wearing was a gift. This was a gift from Gary W. He does a lot of work for Help for Heroes, which is an excellent charity. So that's who this shirt is from. We'll be opening the phone lines later on, gang, if you want to call in. All right, in a little while, I'll open the phone lines as well. Hello to Winnipeg in Canada. How cold is it in Canada today? I bet it's colder than it is here, isn't it? Hello to Lily. She's lovely. Lily is one of our lovely karaoke singers. Gustav, it does go on forever. What, that 3 minutes? That's the idea of a 3 minute countdown, dear. It lasts 3 minutes. Now, can you work out in your small mind, Gustav, why you would put on a 3 minute countdown before the show? Any idea? Is a little light come on in your head at all? Why I would bother to put on a 3 minute countdown rather than just going straight into it? Any idea? Go on, have a little guess. Have a wild stab in the dark. Oh, no talking of stabbing today, dear. Been enough death as it is. Oh, on and on. Anyway, there's some more messages here. Gustav, hello to Terry, who misses the countdown. Oh, did you miss the countdown? Oh, do you want me to play it again? Oh, no, I better not play it again. Gustav will go mad. He won't understand. He doesn't understand why there is a countdown. God's sake, man. Hello to John Coops. Merry Christmas to you. And Justin, there you go. You see, his pub was busy up to 10:30 on Christmas Eve, and then it went quiet. And it's a real change around to what used to... by the way, Justin, keep watching. I'll tell you what that is in a minute, because I don't think you know what that is. I will tell you what that is in a minute. Don't go away, dear. Yeah, it's a real change around, because we used to do Christmas Eve in there, and we'd open, I think, at about 7 o'clock, if I'm right. And people would come in, and they would be there till the end. And something changed, and people started going in there at daytime and then just simply going home at night. So that's when we kind of gave up on that one. But we had a good run of that, and I must say, I did enjoy working with you, Justin. I really did, darling. You were one of the better managers. Just, only just done. Hello to Sean. Says, hope you had a good Christmas. Yes, I did. I'm going to share you some of my presents that I got from family and friends, if that's all right. You may have already seen the show 2 shows ago. I did the Christmas Day show where I opened all my presents from lovely listeners and karaoke people. And that was one of them, Justin. That was one of them. I tell you, you obviously don't know what that is. You're not keeping up, dear, are you? I mean, you just pop in now and again. I understand that. Most people actually pop into this show now and again. They're not there for the whole or every single show. Probably gets a bit too much, does it? I mean, is it too much to say? Could you possibly watch a little bit of me every day? Are the shows too long for you, darlings? Is it too... Can you not hold concentration that long? God, man. Hello to Ross. What did Ronnie give you for Christmas? Ah, now the thing is, Ross, I don't want to tell you that, because I've left that particular item in the car. The only reason it's in the car is because I popped round to his house this afternoon. I got in from my little holiday at my sister's, and then I had something to eat. Then I popped round to his house. We swapped presents, and then I came back, but I hadn't emptied the other presents. So I got one lot in, and I felt really tired. So I went to bed, and I got up, and I was mucking around with this, and I noticed there was a new app for Facebook on Windows 10. Which you could use to directly broadcast. Anyway, we tried it out and it was good, but not as good as this particular program that I use, because you didn't have the whole picture. You had like a little bit of the side there. And then you can't see all of this then. That's the only thing. You saw like this bit here. you know, only this bit of my head was filling the screen. It filling the screen. So we went back to using this. And then I thought, oh, shall I go outside? And I poked my nose, which is quite long. It's quite long, my nose. I poked my nose out the door to the horror of my cat that started meowing because she hasn't seen me for a few days. Meow, meow, meow. Oh, she hasn't seen me. So she started moaning. And I thought, oh, it's too cold. So I came back inside. And you won't see Ronnie's present today. You will see it tomorrow, I think, or the day after. Depends. We won't do a show tomorrow. No, because this will be today's and tomorrow's show. Oh, incidentally, of course, we haven't done today's birthdays. Can I do those very quickly before we carry on? Because there's only two of them. Just a moment now. Today's birthdays, so that is Tuesday the 27th of December 2016. We have two birthdays for you this morning. Hazel Dunsire is 66 today. Hello, Hazel, 66. Now, are you one of the Manilow girls? Let me see if I recognise you. Oh, I don't know, Hazel. I'm not sure if you are. Let me see if you've got anything about Barry on your wall there. I'll tell you what that is in a minute, Justin. Don't worry. No, I don't. I'm not sure that you are. Let's have a look. One mutual friend, Ben. No, I don't think you're one of the Manilow girls, are you, Hazel? It doesn't matter, darling. Everyone's welcome. Happy birthday to Hazel today, 66. Fantastic age. And happy birthday today to a new friend of mine who just joined us on Facebook, Andrew Moyes. I don't know how old you are today, Andrew, but happy birthday to you as well, sir. Okay. The other birthdays for Wednesday the 28th will come up a little bit later on towards the end of the show. All right, so we'll do them all in one go today. That's it. Now let me have a look here. We were doing these. Hello to Terry H, dedicated viewers there, watches every single show from the beginning to the end. Yes, Matt Martens watches each and every show religiously in the name of the Father, the Son and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Hello to Laura, who is one of our wonderful karaoke singers. Hope you had a fabulous Christmas. Yeah, I'm going to tell you all about the other bits in a minute. Justin still wants to know what this is. Patience, Justin. You really will get a heart attack or something like that, having to rush. You're like, well, some people that I know, dear. You rush, 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 dear. Rush, take it easy. Take a bloody chill pill, man, as Nan says. Ow, ow. Nice to see you. Come up and see me. You come up and take a chill pill. Am I being played in the pub, incidentally? I think this could be an attraction to your pub. If I did a late night show, perhaps because I've got two nights off a week now. I've dropped two nights because it's time for poor old Chris to slow down. I'm getting very tired, dear, very tired. So I now have two nights off a week. And I may do a live show on one of them. I haven't decided yet, okay? So you could play this show. Do you want to know what that is now? I'll tell you in a minute. I told you, don't rush me. I don't like being rushed, dear. Hello to Mark Aldrich, says, what's going on in Central in the new year? I'm there, actually, on New Year's Eve. I'm there New Year's Eve. I'm just doing a little bit of DJing, and there's a drag act on as well. That's at Central Station New Year's Eve. Okay, hello to John Coops. I think, is that everyone I've done now? Oh, it's going to get down to minus... Oh, is that all? Minus 45. Matt says it gets down to minus 45. Well, we're looking at about minus 5 here today. But I'm nice and cosy in my room with my nice Help for Heroes shirt on, provided by the lovely Gary W. Thank you very much, sir. I'll tell you what this is now, shall I? Now, I can't take this off the wall. All right. But this was given to me as a present from the Manilow girls. Three of the Manilow girls. Eloise, who won this, she won this in a, I don't know if you'd call it a raffle or what, actually. It's for the Manilow Music Project. These girls raise money for it. There's Rachel, there's Anne, and Eloise, I think, is a member as well. And she won this in like some sort of competition, I think possibly a raffle type thing, not necessarily where you get tickets and you've got a tombola, dear. No, Justin, darling, tombola. You're amazing. Justin is amazing. He runs a little place up in Hemel Hempstead called the Steam Coach. And he's managed to stock and furnish the entire pub out of tombola prizes. Oh, yes. He goes around to jumble sales and things like that, you know, buys a ticket for 10 pence or something like that. And then suddenly he wins prizes, and then there's another table there and there's another chair there. It's amazing what you can do for nothing. It really is, dear. really is absolutely amazing. And all the stock. I mean, you know, if I were you, if you buy a pint in his pub, I'd ask to look at the date on the barrel downstairs. I would. Not that I'm one to talk or spread malicious rumours about anyone, but your health, viewers, your health is my concern. And if you have a pint in there, I'd ask to see that sell-by date. I would. Anyway, so this was won by one of the Manilow girls, and it is the 40th anniversary Manilow. It's like a silver disc in there. And it says at the bottom, Billboard Hot 100, number one, January the 18th, 1975. And if that isn't enough, it's signed by the great Barry Manilow himself. Oh, Mandy, well, you came and you gave without taking. And I miss you again, oh, Mandy. As you can hear, the orchestra is off tonight, so I'm having to sing without the orchestra. No orchestra tonight. Thank you very much. So that's what that is, Justin. Have you got one of those, lovey? Have you got a little signed picture that Barry Manilow has actually touched? Look. Oh! Barry Manilow has touched that, dear. Touched it. He's touched that and signed it. It's not like a stamp, dear. Not like one of those rubber stamps, dear. No, it's actually signed. Thank you very much. How blooming marvellous is that? So that, my dear, is exactly what that is, Justin. And I think you might want that, lovey. I think you might want that, mightn't you? Would you like me to leave that? Oh, no, because you'll be going first, won't you, dear? Oh, yes, you'll be going first. So I can't really leave you anything, I'm afraid. No. Justin has replied, in 1975, I was minus three. Weren't you 18? I beg your pardon. 63, 73, 74, 75. I was 12 years old in 1975, and it was a happy time of my life. It really was. 12 years old, no troubles, no bills to worry about. You haven't got to worry about upsetting anyone because everyone's, oh, it's all right. It's only Christopher. He only made a little mistake. Now they go mad, don't they? Hey, they go mad. Laura says she's heading off to bed now. Good night, Laura. Did you want me to sing you a lullaby? Go to sleep, go to sleep. Good night, Laura. Have a nice time. Have to work tomorrow. That's it. Bye-bye, darling. Where do I do karaoke now, John? Have a look on my wall, darling. You obviously don't pay attention. Have a look through my wall. You'll find out exactly where I am on what days, my darling. All right, my love. The next karaoke is on Friday at Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. Okay. Good evening to Ben, who joins us. Had another drink, Ben, have you, my darling? You haven't, surely haven't been, oh, well, you might have been working today. I think I'm right in saying Ben works on the perfume area in Selfridges. I think I'm right in saying that. Matt says, did you watch the Queen's Christmas message? I did. She weren't looking too clever, was she? Do you know what I mean? A little bit concerned about our good old Queen. I'm a big, big fan for the Queen. Big, big fan of the Queen. I didn't think she was looking very well. And right at the end, she usually gives this smile. And the smile was sort of, you know, it wasn't, it was more like, you know, like trying to do it. And I do hope she's all right. I love the Queen. I love the Queen. Hello to Jerry. Robbie's with us today. Hello, Robbie. All right, darling. Robbie was one of the people that was at the dinner table on Christmas Day at my sister's house, which was absolutely lovely. I've had a lovely Christmas, a really, really nice Christmas. To be honest, since my mother and father died, mother in 2000 and dad in 1996, it's never been all that. My sister goes to a great deal of effort to make sure that everyone has a nice Christmas. I mean, the food on the table and, you know, all the other bits and pieces. If you're a mother, you'll know exactly what I mean. She goes to a great deal of effort. And but it's never quite been, you know, it's always been a little bit sad for me. And indeed this year, it was still a little bit sad. But this was the best Christmas, I would say, I've had. For some reason, I'm not quite sure even why, but it was the best Christmas I've had since my mother and father died. So for some reason, everything kind of came together. Do you know what I mean? It did. It really did. and quite a few high spots. I think the highest spot of it is the one on my forehead, incidentally. Can you see it there? It's gone down a lot now. I am this evening. What I want to do is support the Asian community by having one of these now. That's it. That's what I've done there. We should support everyone. I'm supporting the Asian community like that. The gay community. I'm going to have a handbag on. Let's upset everyone this evening. Let's upset everyone, shall we? Eh? I'm even going to have a red armband to support the Labour Party tonight. I really. We're going to support everyone this evening. Everyone. Yes, my high spot, I think, was round my niece's house last night, Boxing Night. And I was just sitting in the living room with my niece and her little girl, Emily. And all of a sudden, her little boy, George, was in the kitchen. And he came in and he says, "Chris," I said, "Yeah, can you help me with my tooth shark thing?" And his little, "Can you help me with my tooth shark thing?" And that really did it for me. That really did it for me. If I could explain what a tooth shark thing, it could have been anything. Can you help me with, I don't know, snakes and ladders, Ludo, Monopoly? Probably a bit old he's probably not old enough for Monopoly or something like that. But he had come in on his own and asked me to help him with something. Isn't that lovely? And that, I think that was the high spot of my whole Christmas, really. It was. Now, if I can just explain, this tooth sharp thing is probably one of the most annoying things I've ever had to do. What it is like a pretend rock, okay? Which I think is probably made out of some sort of plaster stuff. It looks like a plaster stuff. And it comes with like a couple of plastic tools, which are a little bit like chisels, but it's obviously not metal. I mean, it's like plastic. And you hold this plastic thing and you've literally got to scrape away at this plaster until you find three shark's teeth, which are not shark's teeth, it's a plastic, you know, but plastic in the shape of shark's teeth. Well, you've never come across anything so annoying, and all you're scraping and scraping and there's nothing. And the rock is this big. The rock is about that big, and the teeth are about, and there's three of them in different places, are about that big. And it's so, I gave up in the end. And my niece had to take over, and she really did. So, do not, if you want to keep a child quiet, then buy them one of those. It lasts for ages. Oh my God, hours. I don't know how much it is. Let's have a look. So, let me have a look on Amazon for you. Amazon, find a shark's tooth. Let's try that. Tooth, I don't know, will that work? Shark tooth, here we are. Shark tooth, here we are. £12, that's not bad. You will, if you buy that for your child, you will have ages of fun. It would take them ages to do that, because you're scraping away at this damn thing and nothing happens. And more is cut. And the mess! Oh, my God, the mess, dear! I'm so glad it wasn't in my house. The mess that this thing makes is just powder all over the place. It's horrendous. Horrendous, dear. Horrendous. Hello to Gary. Sent you a Christmas message. Sorry, Gary, I've had so many messages. I haven't kept up with them all. I do apologise, darling. Thank you for your message. Hello to Mary. Terry, we like a big head. What, this, that size? You don't want me that close to the camera, do you? I'm sure you don't. Elijah, what program do you use for this broadcast? If you type in, let's have a look. How to broadcast. If you type in how to broadcast from your computer to Facebook Live, you should find that, my darling, all right? Just type that in. How to broadcast? Have I just? I haven't just closed this down, have I? I might have just. Have I just shut down the show, or is that still running? Hang on, I can check, can't I? No, it's still there. We're still there. Sorry, silly old fool. I thought I'd just shut down the blooming thing there. Never mind. Let's have a look. There we are. Sorry about that. Yeah, I thought we'd shut down the show then. Hello to the Reverend Ted. Good afternoon. Good evening, Reverend Ted. Hope you're well as well. Daniel's with us as well. Oh, you sent it by text. No, I don't think I got that, darling. Don't think I've got that. Ah, Justin. Ben works on Harrods. He does the perfume at Harrods. I beg your pardon. Oh, he's not the perfume counter. And what's he do then? He does something to do with perfume. I know that. Good. So very. Oh, my poinsettia. I don't know what's happened to this. Look, it's all kind of. I don't know what's happened to my poinsettia, which is a shame. Ray Reynolds bought me this. And it looked rather marvellous when I left, and it's not dried out at all, but it's kind of, maybe it doesn't like the position there, so it's going to have to go, I'm afraid. Sorry, Ray. Now, the funny thing is, Ray, I think, you know that other rubber plant you bought me? Ray gives us plant now, isn't it? Ray Reynolds, who I gave the wrong Christmas present to this year. He buys us plants as well. And I don't know why, but for some reason, the plants Ray buys us do not survive here. And I'm very good with plants. I've got a lovely garden out there and the plants, the orchids. I had an orchid behind there for months, wasn't it? Flowering for months. Unbelievable. But for some reason, Ray Reynolds' plants die on me. I don't know why that is. Now, I can show you some of my presents. I'll open the phone line as well, just in case anyone wants to call in. OK, now, if you've got Skype, you can use Skype. Oh, by the way, yes, that was. Did I tell you that was donated by Eloise? I did tell you that, wasn't it? Eloise. It's Eloise, Rachel and Anne that got together. And Eloise won that and she sent it to me as a present. Isn't that lovely? Isn't that a wonderful thing to have on my wall? It really is. But the only thing I haven't done with Barry now is met him. I don't know if that will ever happen. I don't know. I don't know if I... Sometimes you've got an idea about people and... if you meet them, that idea can change, can't it? I'm sure. So I don't know. Maybe I'll meet him someday. Maybe I won't. Now, I'll open the phone line then. If you've got Skype, okay, if you've got Skype, you can Skype in with, you know, high quality sound. Please don't send your video, all right? If you try and send your video, I'll stop it because it uses up quite a lot of bandwidth for video. So and I've already got one video going out to you. So we don't really want another one coming into me because it'll start using up all the bandwidth and we get jiggery pictures and losing sound and all that sort of thing. So I will cancel that. But if you want to Skype in, the Skype is, all one word, United Kingdom Talk. Okay, the Skype in is United Kingdom Talk. Haven't got Skype, doesn't matter. I've got a local London number you can use. 020-8144-3477. I can put that up on the screen. If you're watching a recording of the show, you won't see the number. It's only the people that are watching the show live. The number will come up, or has come up at the bottom there, okay? So if you want to call in, you can do so. It's 020-8144-3477. Now, being as it's only me sitting here, I can only take one call at a time. It's kind of first come, first serve. So if I'm on a call and you ring, it will just keep ringing or it might go to answer phone, OK? Can only take one call at a time. I can't sort of take one. Oh, hello, how are you? And then the phone's ringing. I can't go, just a minute. Hello, I'll call you back in a minute. Can't do that. Not technically possible, I'm afraid. So if I am on a call with someone, if anyone does call in, sometimes people don't call in, which is fine as well, then I can't take another one. So once again, that phone number, 020-8144-3477. Local London number. It's not a premium rate thing or anything like that. 020-8144-3477. Now, that was what I was going to tell you. I have just set up one of my Christmas presents from Adam the Plumber. Now, I think I got the box in here somewhere. And it's a wonderful thing. Here it is. And it was here somewhere. That's it. Let's just close something there. I'm just going to take a couple of messages off Skype. Otherwise, I'll get confused and think that's a message waiting to come in there, won't it? Just a minute now. Okay. Right. Oh, the Mirrorball. Where's the Mirrorball? Well, that's what I put up for Christmas. Now, I'm not sure what to do. Perhaps you'll tell me what you fancy, okay? Apart from me, obviously. Shall I put the Mirrorball back up? Or should I replace it with a globe? Would you like a globe going round there? What do you reckon? Or a globe here as well? We could have a Mirrorball and a globe. or a globe or a mirror ball. What do you fancy? Might think about doing that. If you want both, that would be a little bit of work for me. Oh, and I do hate work, as you well know. As you well know. Now, Matt wants a globe. Look, straight away, a globe. What do you reckon? Oh, my sister's with us. Hello, Sharon. Did you hear me talking about you earlier? I said nice things about you today. Isn't that unusual? Yes. So, actually, can I show you something my sister sent me? Just before, quickly. She makes food. She makes food. Look at this, look. Just a minute, let me get me back. I've got a bag full of stuff here to show you today. This might be a very long show. It'll be a long show until you all start going. Then I'll finish, all right? There we are. Look at these things she's made me here. Look. Oh, I've got loads of it. Mmm. All right, 1 minute. 1 minute. My sister has made me... Here's my favourite. You ready? My favourite. Mmm. Vanilla fudge. Look at the size of that bag. You don't get that down in the shops, do you? Oh, I'm very, very tempted to have... I haven't had a bit of this yet. Actually, shall I have a bit now? Shall I have a bit now? Oh, I shouldn't really. No, because it might muck up me the way I'm talking. It kind of gets... Do you know what I mean? You've got to get... Have to have a little... cup of tea or something with. I've got no drink up here today. That was stupid, wasn't it? And she's also made me, for the first time, orange creams. Actually, I'm going to have one of these. Let's just sample one of my sister's orange creams. You want one, don't you? You want one. Look. Oh, one minute. I'm going to have just a little bit. Oh. Oh, they are delicious. Look at the size of the bag there. Yes. Incidentally, if you come to my karaoke nights, okay, or my quiz nights, I won't be bringing these with me. They're for me. Me. Thank you. Mm. They are delicious, Sharon. Absolutely delicious. Oh, you want me to try the... Do you want me to try the fudge as well? Gustav says he wants the mirror ball back. Okay. Wants the mirror ball. John says a globe. Oh, it's going 50-50s. The globe is a bit BBC 1980s. We like BBC 1980s. Even better, BBC 1970s. Isn't that annoying? That's like having... Perhaps I should take that to the cinema with me. 1 minute. I can't get it open. What have you stuck this down with, sis? Is this super glued? Is it like dieter's fudge that you can't open? I can't get this open. What I'm worried about is breaking the bag. And then the... Oh, here we go. Oh, the smell of fudge. It's good condensed. Is it condensed milk? Condensed milk? Mmm. 1 minute, 1 minute. I'm just going to have a small piece. Here's my... Oh. Dear sister, you have excelled yourself, darling. Thank you very, very much. Absolutely delicious. What a shame I haven't got enough to share with you. Oh, it really is. Perhaps you'd like my sister to make you some fudge. Would you like that? She's on here, Sharon Butler. Just send her your order and she'll do it. How much do you want for that, eh, Shal? £10 a bag. There you go. Nice big bag of fudge like that. £10. Not the crap you get. It doesn't taste anything like the crap you get in a shop, do you? Or, you know, £10 a bag would be cheaper than buying this in a cinema. I'm telling you that now. Have you ever bought a cup of fudge in a cinema? Comes about 15 quid, thieving bastards, dear. 1 minute. So very, very nice that was. Thank you, sis. Absolutely beautiful that is. Daniel wants me to keep this. Oh, no, that's only the Christmas one, dear. It's like my Christmas ball. Just a little bit different for Christmas because we never actually got around to getting the tree up, did we? It's still in the loft. Bit late now, dear. The only Christmas tree I had this year was a little Christmas tree that the caravan site actually put in my caravan. When I got there Christmas Eve, I picked up the keys and I opened the door and I was hit with this wall of heat. They put the heating on in the caravan. The television was on. There was a light on in the living room. And on the little table, in front of the tow, they'd put a little lit Christmas tree and a little snack of crackers on the dining table, and then two mugs full of hot chocolate packets and marshmallows. What a lovely touch. What a lovely, it's, you know, it's attention to detail like that that makes things stick out. I could have just gone, pick up the keys, gone into a cold, fat caravan, had to put the eating on myself. No, it was all ready. It was all ready for you to just walk in and kind of start your holiday. And I'm really, really impressed with that. That was, and it's a lovely place if you want to visit it. They do static caravans, or if you've got a caravan or a tent, you can go there and camp. And have a look at it when I finish the show. It's called Tattershall Lakes Country Park. Tattershall, T-A-T-T-E-R-S-H-A-L-L, Tattershall Lakes Country Park. And it's a, such a, it's all round beautiful lakes. And you go fishing there. And that that thing where you ride on the water, what's that called now? Not a boat. Jet skiing. You can jet ski there. There's a bar in there, an entertainment area. That's all brand new. It's, and if you forget anything, there's a little shop there, which is not overpriced either. I know sometimes you go away to these holiday places and they, you know, it's like £10 for a bottle of shampoo. It's not like that there. Really, really nice. So very nice indeed, yes. Right, now, let's just do these. I'll keep these, try and keep on top of the messages, dear. I like to keep on top of the messages. Hello to, 1 second, please. Trying to connect you. Oh, have we got there? Hang on, I'm looking at the wrong messages here, I think. How does that work? Is it that one there? There it is. There it is. There it is. Yes, he, yes. I'll be honest, I'd quite like a globe there. I would. Maybe a globe. It means putting another motor up, though. It really does. And that's a bit of effort, that. It's effort, dear. Effort. Unless I put the mirror ball up and a globe under the mirror ball. I suppose that could be possible. I'll work on that. I'll work on that. Anyway, I was just testing out, as I was saying, one of my Christmas gifts as purchased for me from Adam the Plumber. And it's this. It's a it's a toilet light. You heard right. Yes, a toilet light. It's called the original light bowl. Here it is there. Original light bowl. Okay. Can you see that? Oh, it's a bit low down. Oh, hang on a bit. Because we've got two cameras in front of us here, a live one and a recorded one, you see. So I'm not looking, if I'm not quite looking at you, then I'm looking at the other people, you see. Right, so there it is. It's a light bulb. And it goes, it hangs over your toilet. All right, can you see that? So there's, there would be your toilet. It hangs over that. And it automatically detects. I like that word, detects. It automatically detects when you approach the toilet and a little light comes on. And it's all different colours. It scrolls through the colours, or many, many different colours, as you can see from the picture there. And it's fantastic. You know, and I don't know about you, chaps, but occasionally, you know, I don't like to turn the toilet light on. I don't know why. I mean, you wouldn't notice it on your electricity bill. But for some reason, if I want to get up to go to the toilet at night, I don't like to turn the light on in case it wakes me up a little bit more than I really am. So you kind of, you know, oh, you know, you wake up a couple of times at night. Oh, I want to go wee. You know, and you kind of get out of bed, trying not to wake up too much, don't you? And you kind of pat over quietly to the toilet. I don't like to turn lights on, as I say, because I feel that that might wake me up more than I am already. And then you kind of just roughly judge where the toilet is and you go for a wee, and then you go. Isn't it funny? You never really wake up to go number twos, do you? Have you noticed that? Does anyone wake up to go to number twos? Only number ones. Only wees. Don't, not for number twos. Not for sit downs. Isn't that strange and mysterious? Yes. So I go, you know, and you kind of, you know, roughly where it is, and then you go, and then maybe the next morning, you know, you get up and go to, and you think, oh, there's a little pool of water on the floor where you didn't quite miss, where you didn't quite get, you know, close enough to the toilet bowl. Well, with this quite dark light, this illuminates the whole of the toilet bowl. Isn't that fantastic? So no longer will you miss. Ladies, do you have the same problem as well? You know, do you get up much at night and have to go to the toilet? And do you miss the bowl as well? Is it just the men that miss the bowl? I know, like, you have to sit down, but I mean, you know, if you were to sort of sit too far forward or perhaps on the side like that, would you also, do you also miss the toilet bowl? Please send in a message and let me know. We need to know these things. We are a hard-hitting news programme and we need to know how this affects you. We really do. The Reverend Ted says, I usually judge by the temperature of the toilet water. Oh, do you check the toilet water afterwards, do you? Do you kind of put a little finger in? Oh, yeah, it's gone warm, so I must have got there all right. Is that right, Reverend Ted? Oh, excuse me. The cough is actually a lot better than it was. Justin says, I'm sure the sensor is quite intimidating by the size of your arse lowering itself down. I don't sit on the toilet, dear, at that time of night. I don't think I've ever, or maybe once or twice in my entire life, have I woken up to do number twos in the toilet. It's only number ones, isn't it? Daniel just puts a bucket next to his bed. Oh, how awful, dear. Well, of course, you're probably used to that. Have you been in prisons? They have to do that in prisons, don't they, Daniel? Yes, they have a bucket. Oh, no. And in the morning, they have to chuck it away. How awful. Oh, no, I couldn't stand it. It's like this business with caravans. Now, obviously, the caravans I stay in, they're static caravans. They're all plumbed in, you know, proper toilets. There's nothing to empty or fill up. It's all pipes coming into the caravans. But with the mobile caravans, you wouldn't have any of that, would you? You'd have to physically empty a toilet. Oh, no. Apparently, there's some quite good ones. It's like a cassette. And as you use it, and then I think a top closes. But you still have to, surely you still have to empty this out somewhere. My mate Ron says, there are some caravans. He says, isn't it like boats? And if you, perhaps you've got a trailing caravan, I don't know. But isn't it, and some of the boats, right, you attach like a hose to it. And then someone comes and pushes a button and it sucks. It sucks all the rubbish out, dear. How awful. What sort of people want to do jobs like that, dear? Oh, of course they could charge me anything they liked. How much to empty that? £2,000, please. Yeah, please, take the money, dear. I don't want to do it. Oh, no. Or maybe there are some caravans. So, like, you know, you're going down the motorway and you push a button and a flap opens and it all just drops out the bottom. How dreadful, dear. Awful. Can you put it on your garden? Is it any good for plants and things like that? I don't know. terrible things to say, dear. Daniel says, I just go out of the window in the summer. Oh, how awful. Please, dear. I bet all your plants are dead downstairs, aren't they? Dear. Good night, Justin. Justin's off now. Right, let's have a look here. Would you like to see some of my presents? As I say, you can call in if you want to, 020-8144-3477. You don't have to if you're quite happy to sit there and watch. That's all right with me. I could talk for England. I don't need to talk to anyone. But if you want to, that's good as well. 020-8144-3477 is my phone number. OK, so let me show you some of my wonderful gifts. This is something my sister got me. Now, it almost looks like something I could hang there, doesn't it, really? I could hang that there. Now, this is some sort of air freshener. And my sister had one, funnily enough, my sister had one bubbling away in the corner of her living room. And I said to her, oh, that's... And she, unfortunately, she told me she'd got one for Christmas, dear. Spoilt the surprise. I said, well, that's a good thing. And here it is, look. You fill it with water. Right. It's got a button on the top there. I might give you a demonstration of this in one of the recorded shows. So you fill this with water. There, right? There's a maximum level there. And then you put in some smelling oils. Oh, what's this here? Gives the insta. Sorry, I'm banging the microphone now, aren't I? Let's have a look at this. Air vent. Please read. Always disconnect. Do not submerge the top cover. Replace the water every 24 hours. Oh, okay. Do not use chemicals. Use only water-soluble essential oils. So I don't know where you would get these from. Maybe Amazon. I buy a lot of stuff on Amazon. I can't be bothered to traipse around shops anymore. So here, what have we got here? This is lavender. What's it like? I've not opened these yet. So, oh, it's got a top thing on it. Oh, I won't be able to smell unless I take that off, will I? Well, what else has it got? Vanilla. Eucalyptus. Oh, that's nice. Is that quite good for breathing, isn't it? Eucalyptus. Although I have not had a problem with my asthma for a very, very long time. Even with this cough. Even I've got this bit of a phlegmy cough, but it's not affected my asthma at all. Not at all. So I just, I'm going to put this on. I think I might put this on tonight. But will it make the, will it not make condensation in the house? That's the only thing I'm thinking about now. I'll put it on in living rooms, in bedrooms tonight. Hang on a minute. I can't get the top off this thing there. Shall I just make a hole in it and that'll be doing, won't it? One minute. With my United Kingdom Talk pen. 1 minute. That's it. Well, it's not very strong. How much are you supposed to put in? Now, I thought that would be a lot stronger than that. One minute. There's not much in there. Because when you buy something, and if there's something to put in there, they don't usually give you a large one, do they? Because they like you to buy that as extra. Let's try and open that up a bit. Eucalyptus. Oh, it's better. Sorry, a minor technical issue there, boys and girls. We were cut off if you're watching and recording. Okay, Matt, would you like to try again now? I'm sorry about that. I completely cut you off there. Matt's going to call in on Skype, I think. So that is quite nice, that eucalyptus. And it smells like that. You know the obus oil stuff? I think if you've got a cold or something like that, they often tell you to use obus oil and you like sprinkle some of it on your pillow or something like that. So Matt's with us now from Canada. Good evening, Matt.
Good evening, Chris. How are you, mate?
Hello. Lovely to hear you. What time is it there today?
We are at 5:37 p.m.
Okay, so late afternoon.
Yeah, that's right.
How are you? All right.
I'm doing all right. How about you? You had a good Christmas?
Oh, it was wonderful. Yeah, wonderful. You probably saw the little Christmas shows. Had a wonderful time with the children. And of course, there's a little one in your house now, isn't there?
Yes, it was Jake's first Christmas. And he, even though he didn't know what was going on, let me tell you, he was in the spirit of happiness. He was as happy as could be.
You just know they are. Did you take him to church on Christmas morning?
Oh, yes, definitely. Yeah, he was very blessed. Everybody loved his little Santa suit. He was just gorgeous.
Oh, center of attention.
Oh, absolutely. It was fantastic. But yeah, isn't it something how children can bring such a life into your Christmas?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I said to you at the beginning of the show today, for some reason, the children have been around for a while now. Right. But for some reason, this particular Christmas was really good. When my nephew's children came around to my sister's house on Christmas morning, that's Harry and Olivia and Evie. Sorry, not in order of age. There's Evie, Harry, and Olivia. Olivia's right. the little one, severely disabled. Then there's Harry, I think, who's three, and Evie, who's four. Right. And Harry came in and just wanted to sit next to me at the beginning.
Wow.
He just came straight over and jumped up and wanted to sit there and overcame Evie as well. And that's just so nice when they do that.
Definitely. Just feel the love. You really feel it.
It really means the world to me. It really does. And I spent most of the time actually mucking around. I think the adults, and I will include my nephew and niece here now. You see, because they're like 30, 32 and 29. I think they were getting fed up with me mucking around with the kids. good. Miserable people. You see, the trouble is, I mean, it's all very well having nieces and nephews of that age, but now they've got a bit too old. Fortunately, there are new ones coming through for me to play with.
Exactly. Plenty of love. Lots of love to go
on. Oh, it was fantastic. You probably saw, and I kept, and what gets them going is when I threaten to eat their mummies. I do. Do you know what? And I go, do you know what, Evie? I'm feeling quite hungry now. Mummy looks very tasty today. I'm going to eat mummy. And I go over there and start pretending to bite their arms. And they come over and they start hitting me and everything.
Don't touch my mummy.
Yeah. Eat mummy. I'm like that all the time. Eat mummy. And what was the other thing I was doing? Oh, yes. So I'm sitting in on one of the settees.
Right.
There's a couple of games that I mean, no one's ever taught me these things. They kind of just happen with children. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And they would come up behind the settee and just ask to be pulled over. So I'd grab both their hands and pull them from behind me right over the settee. And they'd land next to me. And they kept doing it because you get your arms start aching after a while out of that. Ooh, yeah, oh, my word. My arms were killing me after that. And another thing, in particular, Harry liked to do this one. Harry's my nephew's son, who's about three. He likes to play TikTok. Any idea what TikTok is?
No, I never heard of that, mate.
No. This is, again, something that I've invented. Come on, let's play TikTok. And I grab on the same side of the body. He'll lay down on his side. I will grab one hand and one foot and literally swing him. Tick, tock, tick, tock. Now, Harry is fearless. Nothing seems to frighten him. He's the one that jumped in the swimming pool. Do you remember that? Back in May this year, he jumped in the swimming pool and went, whoa, if I hadn't been watching him, he would be dead now.
Well, yeah, you know. Good thing Uncle Chris was there to save him.
Oh, you can't take your eyes off him in the swimming pool ever.
Not for a second.
Never, ever, ever, for 1 second. Nope. Because if I'd have just turned around and turned around again, oh, where's he gone? I wouldn't have known that he was in the water. That wouldn't have occurred to me, you know. But fortunately, anyway, so TikTok and then TikTok. So, and, of course, Harry's fearless. So you can go as high as you want. And my sister was starting to get worried at one point because his head was almost reaching the ceiling. Oh, what's wrong with these adults? Lighten up a bit, for Christ's sake, people.
Oh, honestly, everybody takes everything way too seriously.
You gotta take risks now and again.
Yeah, exactly. So let me ask you this then, Chris. What is more exercise, playing TikTok or going out for a swim?
I'm used to swimming, so playing TikTok.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, because
it's a couple other muscles that you wouldn't normally use going a bit.
Exactly, yeah. Now, in the swimming pool, they have some classes in there, water aerobics that they do a few times a week. And I've done that a couple of times, and they're all old dears doing that. You know, all in their 60s, 70s. I'm sure some of them in their 80s as well.
Yeah.
And that is really knackering. Oh, my God, that is so much more hard work than swimming. But, of course, you're just kicking your legs and running around in the water, and I don't do that. I suppose if I kept doing it, you'd get used to that as well, wouldn't you, Matt?
I suppose so, yeah.
Do you go swimming at all?
Oh, yes. That's my favorite activity, actually, is to go for a swim. I like to do lots of laps, and even though I'm a bigger guy, I have no problem. If I got to stop, at least I've got all the fat to just let me float. Oh, it's beautiful. Oh, I love it. Yep.
You want to go to the Dead Sea in Israel. I went there a couple of years ago. And literally, you literally take your feet off the floor and you float.
Wow, isn't that something?
That's the easy bit. The hard bit is getting your legs down back on the floor because it's almost like swimming in syrup.
Right.
It doesn't feel like it. It just feels like water, but it is actually quite thick, and you try and get your legs down, and it's a real effort to get them back down again. Oh, you'd love Israel, Matt. You'd love all the... You would so love Israel, because everything you learn about Christianity, it's there. You're there. You are standing at the place of the 10th station of the cross and all that. Everything is there.
Oh, I'd be right into that. I mean, that would be the hub of activity for me. It'd be wonderful.
Yeah, you must do that. You know, look forward to that in the future when perhaps your little boy's old enough to do something like that.
We'll connect in London. We'll meet up with Chris, and he will go for round two of Israel.
Round two, and I will give him TikTok.
Right in Israel. There we go.
Because I laid on the floor after TikToking those two. And I said, right, your turn. Come on, lift me up. And they're trying to pick me up, these two little children. Oh, honestly, I had such a wonderful time there. I really did, Matt. I totally did.
That's wonderful. Oh, bless.
What did you get your little boy for Christmas?
We got him one of these little mats that he lays on, right? And it's got these, like, arms. They look like kind of octopus arms, where it kind of extends out. And it's got all these little bits that you can hang off of these arms. for him just to kind of look at. There's like a little mirror and a whale and things like this, and he can just kind of sit there and oogle at this whole thing. He loves it.
Oh, how lovely. I'm sure he got spoilt rotten, didn't he? Do you have a nice... What do you have in Canada for Christmas dinner? Is it the same as what we have? Or?
Well, I can give you a bit of the menu. We had turkey, ham, potatoes, gravy, corn, stuffing. And then for dessert, they do a... what do you call this? It's like a... We call it a Nanaimo square. Do you guys call it that? Nanaimo square?
No, never heard of what that is.
What about New York slice? You heard of that?
No.
It's kind of like a fudge that has a couple different layers on it, and one of the layers is like this yellow icing. It's just beautiful. Okay.
No, yeah? I've never heard of that. We have a Christmas pudding, but I'm really not a fan. Very, very heavy and rich.
I mean, really, I've heard you talk about that, yeah.
Yeah, not my cup of tea at all, I'm afraid. Ah, so there's a difference in the pudding there. And we also probably wouldn't have corn.
Oh, really?
No, we wouldn't have corn. I quite like corn. I do like corn. Yeah, oh, yeah, yes. Definitely. You put a bit of butter on it or something like that. Isn't that delicious? Corn.
That's just wonderful. Oh, yeah.
Corn on a cob. How do you cook yours?
We get all the corn on the cobs together. We'll scrape all the corn right off of there, right. Boil it up, add a little bit of butter, drain it, and it's just perfect.
That sounds absolutely delicious.
Absolutely. How about after the show? We go out, we go grab ourselves some. There we go.
Yeah, I don't blame you. All right, well, thanks for calling in. It'd be lovely to talk to you, Matt.
Lovely to talk to you, Chris. Take care now, sir.
Happy 2017 to you and your new son there.
Yes, and same to you.
And of course, Heather as well. Happy New Year.
Yeah, same to you, Chris.
Cheerio now.
Cheerio. Bye-bye.
There we are. Matt calling in from Canada there. You can call in if you want to, boys and girls. It's 020-8144-3477. Okay, 020-8144-3477. Or you can Skype in as well. My Skype username is... All one word, United Kingdom Talk. Skype username, United Kingdom Talk. Join up on Skype. Just click the thing there that says United Kingdom Talk and you'll come through to me. Or indeed, use the phone, 020-8144-3477. Some more messages coming in there, boys and girls. Eloise says, love the Manilow Mandy disc. Well, I'm sure you do. You sent it in. Thank you, Eloise. Look, it will remain there proudly. If you're wondering where my other thing has gone, the Chris Reardon Star of Fame, I think I'm going to be putting that here probably when the Christmas star has gone, which is illuminated tonight for you. My Christmas star is illuminated, all right? Let's have a look there. Righto. Now, let's show you some more stuff, shall I, that my family have bought me. Oh, no, this is from a friend. Now, this is really, really nice. This is from Ronnie's boyfriend, because we buy each other's gifts as well. I bought him a scarf, a nice scarf, and he's bought me this beautiful duvet set. And look at this. I'm a big fan of colours. Bright pictures, anything like that. I don't like anything very plain, like people's rooms, they've painted them magnolia or something like that. And bedspreads as well. I'd rather have like a nice pattern on there. Look at this, peacocks. Actually, look, shall I take that out and you'll see it better then? Let me just, there we are. I think you can see the picture there. I'll just take that bit of plastic off there. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Look at that peacock. And it's a bed set, duvet set. And that's so nice, that is. Now, it's not. I won't be putting this on soon because at the moment I have my... what's that called now? Not fleece. Oh, what's it called? Brushed cotton. Flannelette. I have my flannelette duvet sets on at the moment. Okay. This is much more... It'd be like a summer type thing. I might try it out and I'll show you a photograph. So that's Andy. Andy got me that. So thank you very much, Andy. And I know he enjoyed his scarf there. I'm just keeping an eye on what you're sending in as well at the same time there. Hello to Tommy Flynn, who's with us today. Hello, Tommy. Nice to see you the other week. You've been very quiet, dear. Nice to see you the other week. Must have been a little bit difficult without your mother this year, but you've come through it, Tommy. You've come through it, and that's the most important thing, my darling. All right. I think this is from my sister. I'm pretty sure that's from my sister. She bought me a lovely green Ralph Lauren shirt. I hope I'm going to get these people right who bought me these things. Well, that's a worry, isn't it? Actually, that's a worry. Now, I'm sure that was from my sister. Nice green Ralph Lauren shirt, which will, of course, be making an appearance on this show at some point. I might wear that to the quiz tomorrow. I don't know that. And my sister also done me this. A nice nice hooded top. I'm going to actually have to go through my cupboards because what happens, I tend to hoard things. And I've got a lot of clothes in there. Some of the stuff doesn't fit anymore because I'm a bit overweight at the moment. 13 and a half stone now. And I'd like to get back down to 12 stone, which I shall attempt to do very soon now. I'm going to cut out bread, cakes, crisps and chocolate. That should start me off all right. Bread, cakes, chips and crisps and chocolate. They're the things that I cut out before and it does work. Does work, okay. Carbohydrates now. My sister also bought me... Where's that? Oh, here it is. I like tiles. Now, I've got some of these hanging downstairs. And here is another one that she's bought me. Look at that. And that's a ceramic tile. And you can do anything you want with these, really. I like to hang them on the wall. Beautiful, aren't they? All different ones. You get these off Amazon. They're not over expensive. You can get a smaller one like that for about £15, I think. Something like that would be like half that size. That's probably, or I don't, shouldn't really guess how much someone's spent on you, should you? But I would imagine that would be about £25, £30 for something like that. And you get a collection, you start collecting them, put them on the wall. Lovely things. Not from the floor, really, dear. Especially not the way my cat keeps having accidents on the floor now. Oh, I'm forever clearing up from behind her. Poor old soul she is, dear. I don't know why she wheezes in the cat tray and she does number two on the kitchen floor. I don't know why. I've had to put a load of newspaper now in the area that she keeps doing it. That's the only way to do it because she's quite elderly now, I think, and that's the way it goes. Matt says, there's been a poll going on in Canada asking citizens if we should leave the Commonwealth after the Queen passes away. Hope it won't happen. Well, I hope it won't happen as well. I hope she never pass away, dear. We like the Queen. I think she actually watches this show. Now... what else have we got here? So that, I'm going to save something for the next show because it is quite funny. I'm just going to show you it quickly, okay? My niece got me this. This is Perfect Match Grey Root Concealer. All right? Well, that's all I'm telling you at the moment about that, okay? Perfect Match Grey Root. Now, as you can see, you can't really see. I do have grey hair, but because it's so short... You can't really see it. Now, this grey root concealer, she tested this out and it worked quite well. I'm going to put this here next to me. You can't see it there. And it will remind me to show you something and you will die when you see this. But I think it actually worked. Well, test it on. We'll test it on a future show, maybe the next one or the one after, OK? What's this here? I got some lovely biscuits, which are obviously I'll have to eat before we start trying to lose the weight. That is very nice. Now, who were these from? I can't remember who these were. Chocolate Brussels sprouts. Now, some people are asking me, who I've showed these to already, are they actually Brussels sprouts covered in chocolate? No. No, they are completely chocolate Brussels sprouts, okay? That's what they are. They're made of chocolate and they're coloured with some sort of green dye, stuff like that. Very, very tasty indeed. So I've got those. Going to show you some pictures now. Okay, so first picture to come out of the bag is this one. These are two of my great... what do you call them? Great nieces and nephews. So that's George. That's the one who asked me to come and help him with his tooth, shark tooth. Find the shark tooth in the rock. And that's Emily. Isn't she the prettiest thing? Now, last year, she was the most nervous child you could ever imagine. And the slightest thing would happen and she'd burst into tears. She's not so bad now. She's actually got a lot better than that. Very well behaved. Very well behaved children. So there's those two. And where's the other one? I've got another picture here. Here it is. And this was taken when we were on holiday in Euro Disney this year, which I'm afraid I cannot recommend Euro Disney to you. We had a wonderful time, but it's horrendously expensive for the English. It's actually cheaper to take your family to Florida for 10 days than it is to take your family to Euro Disney for 4 days. And once you get there, it's the food is astronomically expensive. Way, way overpriced. Way, way overpriced. So I'm not going to recommend Euro Disney to you. Okay? Once you get there, of course, the whole Disney stuff is fantastic. Don't get me wrong. The rides, the characters, the shows, fantastic. But the rest of it is so expensive. And it would be cheaper for you to go to New York, Florida. It really would. Anyway, so this is a picture of us in Euro Disney. You can see me in my very warm orange coat. And that person there is Harry, okay, who likes TikTok. He's the one that likes TikTok. There is Olivia there in the pram. And there is Evie in a little pink outfit there. So another little photo to treasure there. Such wonderful things that have been bought. They really are. Oh, look, there's another one. Another bag of fudge for little me. Am I ever going to lose any weight to get on this diet? That's the question. Thank you, sis. I didn't know there were two bags in there, dear. I should have to start eating them earlier. When I finish the show, I may go downstairs and have a few of these. I might just do that, you know, sis. Yes. Now, what else have we got here? Here's a little rucksack. That, now, who bought me this? I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do with this. Will I get my swimming stuff in there? I might do. I might get my swimming stuff in there. That's from my sister. She bought me lots of little things, which is really nice. Really, really nice. And then... that's from Gary and Stacey. Gary's my nephew, Stacey's his wife, and they bought me this little Bayliss and Harding hair and body wash and shower gel, which is a nice little thing to get. So, and they're all my presents from everyone, except the present from my mate Ronnie, which is still in the car at the moment. The only reason it's in the car is because I had loads of stuff to carry earlier. And I'll show you that in the next show, OK? I'll show you that or them in the next show. I bought Ronnie a Ring doorbell. Now, this is... it's a camera doorbell, but with something very, very importantly different. It's not just like a camera in the house. Oh, no, it's fantastic. What you do is push the button and immediately, in the space of... no time at all, on your mobile, because you've got to connect the two together, right? So yeah, it involves a little bit of setting up. And I always worry when things involve setting up, but we got it going. You press the bell and there's a camera on it, okay? And immediately on your iPhone, wherever you are in the world, as long as you've got a signal, it rings on your iPhone. And a picture comes up on the person who's pressing the bell. How fantastic is that? Absolutely fantastic. Now, you can get these on Amazon. It's called Ring Doorbell. R-I-N-G Doorbell. And you'll see it there. It's quite a large thing. I would say it's probably about the same size as a normal size iPhone, but thicker. It can be battery operated, in which case you've got to undo the screws and recharge it, say, every 3 months. And you recharge. It's no batteries to put in. You recharge the thing for about, I don't know, 4 or 5 hours. And obviously, for that time, it's not on the front door then, is it? So, or you can drill a hole through the wall or door and connect it straight into a plug. And then you never have to do that again. And you push the button and it rings on your mobile phone wherever you are in the world. And then you can answer it wherever. And not only that, you can talk to the person who's ringing from wherever you are. How fantastic is that? And I got this because my neighbour's got one. No, I haven't got one myself. I bought that for him because my neighbour's got one. And Ronnie was walking past there the other day and he says, what's that? So it's, he said, oh, they're really good. And it got closer and closer to Christmas. And we was walking around the shops and then I saw one in the shop and it reminded me that that's what he mentioned. I checked it out and I thought, yeah, I'll get one of those. So I ordered it off Amazon and it arrived with just a few days to go. and we've just set it up tonight, and it's fantastic. Not only that, not only can you do it on your phone, but you can give other people permission to be able to answer that as well on their phones. So at the moment, I don't know if he said he's going to take it off me, because it does lots of other things as well. Other things as well. For example, even if you don't ring the phone, like if there's a like someone, you know, a burglar or something like that, whenever you approach it, it starts recording. And it saves the recording on a mainframe, on a cloud, on one of the cloud things. Now, if you want to do that, if you want it to save a thing, you do have to subscribe. I think it's something like £2.50 a month or something like that. And then it will save all this stuff on there. If you don't want to do that, doesn't matter, because if you've got to set it up for the range of the motion that you want it to capture. So whenever someone approaches you, even if you haven't subscribed, your phone will say, ah, someone has activated the motion sensor, and you can see who it is, even if they've not rung the phone. Isn't that fantastic? I'm very, very tempted to get one myself, dear. Oh, it's 12 o'clock, dear, already. Is it midnight already, dear? Oh, the time goes so fast when you're enjoying yourself amongst friends such as yourselves. It really is. But yeah, and then you can go back. He's now subscribed, so he can now go back, and me at the moment, because he's given me permission to be one of his receivers. But I think he's going to take me off that, because every time he goes outside now, it sets off my phone, motion detected. I say, oh, you're going out now. He doesn't like that. What a wonderful day to spy on your partners, isn't it? He opened it. He said, oh, you're back then. And he's like, stop doing that. I'm going to have to take you off that. I think he's going to delete me from his thing. But there you go. I think it's a wonderful thing to actually allow someone else to do it, because, you know, you're not always near the phone. Now, I'm not quite sure what happens if someone was to ring it and I answered it before he did. I'm not quite sure what happens there, so we need to do that little experiment there to see what happens. But a highly recommended gadget for you is that. It's called a Ring doorbell, and I believe Amazon have now got it on sale as well. Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. I was going back through, you can go back through the history, you see, because he's now subscribed, about £2.50 a month, and you click a thing and you can see someone who rung earlier. Or who set off the motion detector thing. All in colour, reasonable quality picture. You can certainly make out who it is. Yeah, it's not like little squares and all that. You remember when cameras were first out. Fantastic. The Ring doorbell. So that's what I got him. Have to say, on the way home, now, usually I will travel home at night time. I beg your pardon. The green shirt was from my niece, Tracy. Thank you. Thank you, Sharon. The green shirt was from my niece, Tracy. The torch. I was also bought a torch, which is. That must be in the car then. The torch is in the car. I was bought a wonderful flat, ever so bright. And it's got a red flashing thing on the back, which I was annoying people with on Christmas Day. So thank you. Hello to Craig Adams. He does some hospital radio. Hello, Craig. Just got into bed watching you before Holby City. Oh, I haven't seen that yet. That's on tonight, wasn't it? I haven't seen that. I might have that with a cup of tea and just a couple of small pieces of my sister's delicious fudge. Oh, we love it. We love it. Call in if you want to, 020-8144-3477. 020-8144-3477 is the phone number. Okay, be very nice to talk to you. On the way home, as I say, I would normally travel at night. So what's happened before is Boxing Day, we've had our day, then I've gone to have a sleep, then we've had something to eat, and I've gone home like at 11 o'clock at night. This time, for a change, I didn't actually have my sleep in the afternoon, which frankly really did me in. I mean, I went to my nephew's house, first of all on Boxing Day, visited my sister. I went to the shops with my nephew Jimmy. He's 19. He wanted to get a pair of jeans, so he went into Top Man, and he's looking at all this stuff in there, and I thought, well, maybe I'll get something for me in here as well. And I'm looking through all the stuff, and of course, it's always the same in it. Skinny, super skinny, slim fit, double slim fit, extra slim fit. I mean, where's the normal size stuff? And you look outside, and there's people, most people are fatter than me. How do they ever sell anything? That is the question. Where is the normal size stuff, for God's sake, man? Oh, dear. Anyway, he picked up this pair of jeans, and we got back in the car. And we're driving up. We were in and out of Lincoln in an hour. Now, if I go shopping with my sister, we're not getting back until like 6 or 7 o'clock at night. And I'm so tired by then, really falling apart. Anyway, so I thought I'd get, you know, do it like this and I'd get a bit of sleep earlier. But that wasn't the case, unfortunately. Anyway, so we picked up these jeans and he said, oh, they're nice jeans, but they've got holes in them. And I said, do you want to take them back? Here's another one, bought jeans with holes in the knees. What's all that about? I mean, I keep seeing lads walking around with no socks on. Like, it's the middle of winter, and I've got, like, the bottom of the trousers don't go down past the ankle, and they've got no socks. Don't they get cold ankles walking around like that? Not very good, dear. Is it really? Anyway, so he's bought a pair of these jeans with the holes in the fronts, the holes in the front of the knees bit there. And we came home. And then we went to, we came back to my caravan and I did him beans on toast. It's quite nice to be able to do it. I know he's 19, but he's still a child to me, you know, to come around and do someone a meal like that, isn't it? You know, a young person a meal like that. So he had beans on toast and I had jacket potato on and beans. And then we went around to my niece's. That's when the little boy, George, says, you want to come and help me with my tooth, find a tooth in the rock type thing. And then after that, we went round to my nephew's Gary's and his wife Stacey, and that's the one with, they're the ones with Evie, Harry and Olivia. And I sat down on the chair and I was, and it's by now, it's like, I think it was about 7 or 8 o'clock now. And I hadn't had my 2 hours sleep in the afternoon. I didn't have 2 hours sleep on Christmas Day, but I think I nodded off in the chair. I mean, it's good. It's got to that stage now, you know, where I fall asleep at people's houses if it gets too late. That's the stage I'm at now, I'm afraid. But there you are. That's the way it goes. And and I fell asleep in the chair. I was so tired, so terribly, terribly tired. In fact, apparently my mate rang up, Ronnie, was telling me this day. He said, you sounded so tired the other day. I said, when? He said, well, you spoke to me yesterday when he was at Gary's. And I'm like, did I? I didn't even remember. I was so tired. Anyway, eventually, and I felt bad at that because, you know, usually I'm around there and, you know, and I'm chatting away and playing with the children. And when I woke up, I said, well, I'm like, where's the children? Oh, they went to bed. They got fed up waiting for me to play with them. Never mind. So they'd gone to bed and I was so tired. Anyway, went back to my sister's for a little while. And then I think I went back to my caravan. And usually at this point, I would have gone home. But I thought, no, I might as well. You know, I paid for another night. I might as well stay there. I'll just go tomorrow morning, like normal people do at 9 o'clock, at 10 o'clock. You have to be at the caravan at 10 o'clock. Love caravans. If you know me now, you will know that I've fallen in love. Sorry, I've got a really itchy nose. Can I just blow my nose just a moment? Sorry. Oh, dear. I get a very, very itchy nose sometimes. Don't start. I hope I don't start sneezing. I fell in love with caravans back in May this year when I first went in a caravan, when my nephew Gary and Stacey asked me to go on holiday with them. And I love them because, you know, they're like small luxury houses. They really are. Everything's in there. You know, you get your key, you open, there's the cooking stuff, there's the living room, and they're spotless. Absolutely so clean. So clean. They really are. Like, you've got to get out of them at 10 o'clock in the morning. So I kind of set my alarm for 20 past eight. That'd give me enough time to clear out, sort of thing. And I woke up at about 7:30 in the end because I'd had a good sleep. I think I went to bed at about 11 o'clock. It was like 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's 8 hours. I did go to bed early on Boxing Night. And, of course, not as bad as going to bed Christmas night. You know, I was sitting there recording my show and suddenly the terrible news of George Michael that died. I mean, I just could not believe that. I mean, it was a fantastic day. And to finish off with that terrible piece of news that the very talented and nice person George Michael had died was just horrendous. Anyway, so got up at 7 o'clock, and eventually I was ready at 9. What I do is gradually move everything onto the table that's next to the caravan door, you see. So, and I move it all out. Otherwise, you start leaving things, and gradually the table gets less and less, and then it's all gone. So I went and dropped the keys off at 9 o'clock, and I thanked them very much, in particular for the nice little Christmas touches that made with the Christmas tree and things like that. Drove home. The journey generally takes about 3 hours. Oh, dear. 4.5 hours. And, of course, the traffic starts. It was the M1 where it started. You know, as you approach London, it just gets worse and worse and worse. And usually I'd go then around the M25. M1, M25, M3. Right? But it didn't take me off at the M25. So that must have been really bad. And it took me all the way into London around the North Circular Road, which was also bad. And I sat there crawling along in this traffic. And I'm like, why, oh, why did you not leave at night as you used to do? So I think probably what I'll do next time, I won't leave at like 11 o'clock at night. But what I'll do is I'll go back to the caravan, have a bit of a sleep, and then maybe leave at 5 or 6 in the morning. Actually, five. If I leave 6, 7, 8, no. If I leave at 6, then I'm coming with the traffic. So I might, you know, have a couple of hours sleep. And if I leave then at like 4 in the morning or something like that, I could be back here by 7, and that would be much better. Or I might just travel through the night like I used to. I used to leave there at 11. No, actually 9. I used to leave about 9 o'clock at night. I'll be back here by 12. Easily be back here by 12 o'clock. So I'll do that in future. So there's a lesson to be learnt there, not to travel to London from such large distances at that time of the night there. All right. Okie doke. I think we're done here today, aren't we, really? I've showed you all these gifts. The light, as I say, the light that my sister bought me, that wonderful gadget, is downstairs somewhere. So I shall locate that. Actually, I think it's on the kitchen table there. And I'll show you that another day. Oh, I've got a screwdriver here for some reason. Well, I'm going to leave you there, boys and girls. Oh, let's do today's birthdays. Today's birthdays, because, of course, it's now Wednesday. Being a Wednesday night, I am hosting karaoke tonight, boys and girls. No, I'm not. What is it? Quiz night. It's Wednesday night, so I'll be hosting a quiz tonight. If you want to join us in London at the King's Head Theatre Bar, quiz starts at 8:30 and finishes at 10:30, okay? 8:30 to 10:30 for the quiz tonight. Every Wednesday, but not next week. Every Wednesday, but not next week, at the King's Head Theatre Bar, Upper Street in Islington. That's tonight. Now, today's birthdays then. Happy birthday today to... Now, who's he then? Just a minute. Is that a person or is it a... Oh, I think it is, yes. Sorry. Sorry, I couldn't see your photo there. I do wonder about some people that, obviously not you, Matt, but some, not, this is, sorry, this is another, this is Matt Adams. Matt Adams. I do wonder about, what you know, when you get, like, people, your friends, and there's no pictures. And I think, oh, are you a bit of a dodgy? Because I do get a lot of dodgy requests, usually from women, scantily clad women, with barely any clothes on, wanting to be my friend. And then you read down and it says, oh, for hot fun, look here. And there's a link there. And I report them straight away. I report, we cannot be seeing women's bits and pieces on my Facebook wall, please, dear. No. So I do wonder, sometimes if there's no photo there, I get a little bit dubious. But let's do today's birthdays then. Matt Adams. Happy birthday to Matt Adams today. Happy birthday to Stephen Vavrick, who's 38 years old today. Happy birthday, Stephen. Julie Ho. Is that Holstar? Is that Miss Holstar? I think it is, isn't it? Am I right there? I'm sure it is. Is it Holstar? Is it? Let me see. I'm sure it is Holstar. I'm sure it is, isn't it? I'm sure you're Holstar. Julie Ho. Happy birthday to you. It's been a while since I saw you, dear. When was the last time? Was it a black? I think it was a black cat last time I saw you. Wasn't it sadly closed now, unfortunately, Julie? And happy birthday to Kenney Braithwaite, who's 60 years old today. Keeney. Is it Keeney or Kenny? Because you've got an E there, haven't you? Double N-E-Y. Let me look. I think it might be Keeney, actually. I think it's Keeney. Let me just have a little look at your photo. And I shall detect... I think you're going to be called Keeney. I'm guessing you're going to be called Keeney. So here comes the song, boys and girls. Happy... Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. All right, boys and girls, time for me to go. Thank you very much for joining us for our little live show on this Wednesday night, Thursday morning. And on this Tuesday night, more like Tuesday night, Wednesday morning, and we'll have another chat again.